the next to hit. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Now time is called, and this could very well be to buy a few more pitches for those relievers. Count still at 1-2. Again, a 1-2. Now Bell swings and launches one to right. Looking up is Contreras. That one is out of here. This game is tied.
I threw the motherfucker up high as hell. Caught myself throwing up out the strike zone.
Miles has it on first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. Stepping in, Colin Moran. 2-1. The 2-1. High pop up. Rizzo shading to his right. And he makes the catch for the second out. Now to the plate, number 17. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground. This is line to left. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. Here's Jordy Mercer now, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further.
Lying to shortstop. He's there to make.
Man, that should have been done.
Here's Addison Russell. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Dickerson going back, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And your go-ahead run is in at second base here with a leadoff double. So a big moment in the ball game here. Jason Hayward, and he could very well get the intentional pass here as that would set up a potential double play ball that might keep the game tied. Victor Caratini will grab a bat and hit. The pitcher Felipe Rivero enters from the pen now as they've saved their closer until this deep into extra innings. Next to bat will be Victor Caratini. Harrison into shallow center. Play is made, but they're going to challenge his arm. Throw back to second, and that's a double play. And now here's the versatile outfielder Albert Almora Jr. as he'll hit with the go-ahead run at third and two away.
In my opinion, there is no one in this bullpen that relishes a moment like this on the mound other than this guy. It looks like he feeds off the challenge of pitching in tight games.
Swing and a liner into right center. That's going to be a base hit. A big turning point here as they've taken a lead now deep into extra innings. And he is in there with an RBI triple. So coming to the plate, Kyle Schwarber. Although there are a couple of bases open, we'll see if they think about working around him. Count is 1-2 now. And he strikes him out here for out number. Brandon Morrow is on now, hoping to finally wrap things. Up in the bottom of Sean Rodriguez will pinch.
Sean Rodriguez.
Ball and two strikes to Sean Rodriguez. Slider stayed too low. Ball two. Popped him up. Rizzo has a play. One down. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Josh Harrison struck out after whiffing on a bunt attempt in his first at bat. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Schwarber is going to get there as he backs up to put it away. And there are two gone now. Here's Gregory Polanco, who comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day.
Now pitching for the Chicago Cubs.
Now the 2-1 will not catch the zone, ball three.
A great take on that slider away right there. But I'm thinking in that situation, that pitcher's got to execute a little bit better. That was almost a non-competitive pitch. Being outside, you could almost have let that one go right out of his hand.
Catch is made, and the Cubs finally put this one to bed in 12 innings as the ball game is over. Not a lot of fireworks, but that narrows the candidate list for our top player of the game. And the man you see here was a key contributor, so he takes it home.